Hello. So before going to the main part of the video, I want to say you something. I am making this video specially for CSE Section C students. This video is a basically continuation of my class lecture for CSE Section C students. So if you are outside from the Section C students, so if you have proper background about eigenvalue, eigenvectors of a matrix, then you also can join this video. So from there, let me start up from there. So what we are going to do, so we going to do something that suppose we are talking about the eigenvalue and eigenvector of a square matrix. Suppose we have a diagonal matrix. So diagonal matrix means suppose we have a diagonal square matrix A. I am taking a 3 by 3 diagonal matrix. Suppose we have 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0 and 0, 0, 2. So this is a 3 by 3 diagonal matrix. Now what we going to do, we going to find out the eigenvalues of the matrix, which means we have to find the first determinant of A minus X into identity matrix equals to 0. So if I do this, what we get 1 minus X 0 0 0 1 minus X 0 0 0 0 0 2 minus X, and this gives 0. So if I find out the determinant, we get 1 minus X 1 plus X, basically minus 1 minus X means 1 plus X, and 2 minus X equals to 0. So this is the characteristic equation of the diagonal matrix A. So from there, what we get the roots of this equation are x equals to 1, x equals to minus 1 and 2. So the eigenvalues of the matrix, we know that eigenvalue of the matrix is the roots of the characteristics equation of the matrix. So what we get, the eigenvalues are 1, minus 1 and 2. So if you very carefully look at the matrix, you can find that the eigenvalue of the matrix are the diagonal entries, are the entries of the matrix. So instead of 2 or 3 by 3 matrix, if I take a 2 by 2 matrix, so suppose I just take any 2 by 2 matrix. So let me erase that first. So if I take a 2 by 2 matrix, or just let me take a 4 by 4 matrix. So if I take a 4 by 4 matrix, so for example, I am taking a matrix B, which is a 4 by 4 matrix. So suppose we have 1, 0, 0, 0, 4 by 4 diagonal matrix, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. And 0 0 0 2. I am taking all the entries of the diagonal are non-zero. So we have a diagonal matrix. If I find the characteristic equation of B, so characteristic equation of the matrix B is basically, if you find the determinant of B minus X into a 4 by 4 identity matrix equals to 0. So which gives, if we do this, you will find by yourself, suppose the video and find by yourself, you will clearly find, it's very easy to find, it will be our 1 minus X minus 1 plus X, 1 minus X again, and 2 minus X equals to 0. From there, we get the values of the x were 1, minus 1, 1 and 2. So the eigenvalues of the matrix, so eigenvalues of the matrix B are 1, minus 1, 1, 2. So if you look very carefully again, so you will find that the eigenvalues are the diagonal entries of this diagonal matrix. So basically what we have for any diagonal matrix, so if you look at the pattern, so you can find that out. So for any diagonal matrix, eigenvalues of the matrix, so let me write the conclusion. So from there we have the following conclusion. So first let me erase this first. So remember this conclusion. So conclusion from that, that any the eigenvalues of a diagonal matrix is the diagonal entries of the diagonal matrix. So because we have find out eigenvalues, it will be very easier to find the eigenvectors for the matrix. So what we are doing over here, so we are doing something in this chapter. We are finding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. That's a very important thing, and why they are important we have already discussed in our classes. So here we have easily, it's very easy to find the eigenvalues for a diagonal matrix. You can see that. So if we have 100 by 100 matrix, that will be very easy to find the eigenvalues, because for the 100 by 100 matrix, all the diagonal entries of the matrix will be the eigenvalues for the matrix. Now the question is, so suppose we have a matrix A which is not a diagonal matrix. Suppose we have a square matrix. So here we have working with the question, something very important that was hunting the mathematicians over the time. So if we have a matrix, so suppose A is n by n matrix, any n by n square matrix, so we have to find the eigenvalues of the matrix. So we can obviously find that out by A, determinant of A minus xi equals to 0, and the roots of the equations will be the eigenvalue of the matrix A. But if we have a 100 by 100 matrix, so if we have some higher order square matrix, it's not a very easy appeal for even for a supercomputer to find the eigenvalues of the matrix. Forget about you, you can not even find the determinant of a 4 by 4 matrix. That's a very difficult task sometimes to find the eigenvalues of the matrix. Now the question is, in some sense, is it possible that in some sense, the question is it possible in some sense A is somehow in some sense is similar to a diagonal matrix, so that all the eigenvalues or all the eigenvalues of A are equal to the eigenvalues of that diagonal matrix here you have a question. In some sense, if A is similar, so is it possible that we can define the concept of some similarity, that A is similar to some diagonal matrix D. So in some sense, we are going to define what is the notion of similar. We have to define that very carefully. Why? Because otherwise, because here is important that we are defining the concept of similarity in some sense that the all the eigenvalues of A are the all the eigenvalues of the diagonal matrix. Because for a diagonal matrix, all the entries of the diagonal are the eigenvalues. So if we find a matrix which is some way similar to a diagonal matrix, so the all the eigenvalues of the matrix D, which means all the diagonal entries of the diagonal matrix, will be the eigenvalue of the matrix A. So if we have a non-diagonal n by n matrix, so suppose n is 2020, so if we have 2020 into 20 square matrix, and if I ask you to find the eigenvalues of the matrix, so you can find that out easily, because if this matrix is similar in some sense to a diagonal matrix, that will be a very easier thing than to calculate this determinant part. That's the important, very important question. So we have to define very carefully what is the concept of similarity. If I can define the concept of similarity, then we can easily do all such things very easily. So let me go into the concept of similar matrices, or the concept of similarity. So here we go. So first let me erase this part. Okay, so here is the concept. So it says that, so here we are defining the concept of similarity. So let me write that down, the similar matrices. So we are defined similar matrix, the concept of similar matrix. So why, what is that concept? So here we have the definition. A square matrix, A, so suppose A, this A, square matrix, so suppose a square matrix A is similar to a square matrix, B. So obviously the order of A is same, have to be same with the order of the matrix B. So A is similar to a square matrix B if we find a invertible, so a non-singular, invertible means a non-singular square matrix matrix P, such that A can be written as A equals to P inverse, because the matrix P is the one singular matrix, so it has an inverse matrix. So A is basically P inverse BP. So this means we are multiplying B with P and then multiplying with P inverse, or you can multiply P inverse with B then multiply with P, they gives the same thing, because matrix multiplication is associative. So if we have something like that. The matrix A is similar to the matrix B if A can be expressed. If we find a matrix, it's not always that we can find a matrix, a square non-singular matrix P, but if we find a non-singular matrix P such that A equals to P inverse BP, then we will say that A is similar to the matrix B. Also use that notation. So A is similar to the matrix B. So that is how, this is called the definition, that is how the concept of similarity is defined. Okay, so let's go to see some example. So any matrix, so here we have some example, or also you can say some notes. So examples, we are working with one by one. We have to go we have to take each step very carefully. So I am saying that the matrix A is similar to itself. So A is similar to the matrix A itself. Why? Because we can write A equals to the identity matrix I inverse A I, because A into I gives A again, and again I inverse into A also gives A. So A can be written as A equals to I inverse AI, and we know that obviously that I is a invertible matrix, so A is similar to the matrix A. So next one is, let me give you another thing, another example, or you can say as a note, that if A is similar to the matrix B, A is similar to B, then B is also similar, it's a very, it's natural, then B is similar to A. Why? If A is similar to B, then we can find the matrix P, so that P inverse B P equals to A. Now what we know, that we know that P inverse whole inverse is P again. So what we going to do, we write it is in this way. So what we can do, or you can also find that out, you don't have to use that, just multiply both side by first P. So also you can write from here, we don't have to go through all this process. So multiply P both side in right hand side. So P into A is P P inverse B P. So it gives us B P, because P P inverse is I, so we get B P. Now multiply with P inverse both side, P A P inverse, we get B P P inverse, because P into P inverse is the identity matrix, so we get B again. So you can see that now what we can write from here, that B equals to, so B equals to P A P inverse. So now we, what we have written, so write that down. So we can write is as P, P can be written as, so let me erase the this portion and write it over. So if we can find that down, so what we can write, we have, so from there what we have B equals to P A P inverse. So what we going to write in this way, that first we have to the inverse sign. So here we have no inverse sign, so for that what we going to do, we write P equals to P inverse whole inverse A, and here we have P inverse. So what we going to do, P inverse equals to Q, so we can write is as Q. So Q equals to P inverse, which is an invertible matrix. So B can be written as, we have find out a matrix Q which is invertible, and B can be written as Q inverse A into Q. So B is similar to the matrix A.